The next two tools I will be talking about are very useful in catalog retouching. Press W to select one of them and Shift W to switch between the two. The first one is the Magic Wand tool. Sounds promising, right? When you click it on the image, it selects pixels according to the tolerance setting. The more this value is, the more pixels of similar color will be selected. If you check the contiguous box, it will select pixels only in the area where you click the tool. No tick in the contiguous box means the tool will work with the whole images, selecting pixels of similar color everywhere. Similar to the color picked from where you click it, of course. When you use this tool in catalog retouching, make sure you have the Add to Selection button pressed in the tool options, because you'll most probably have to click a few times to select something right. And while we can add selections to each other by holding Shift while clicking, pressing the button will save us the worry. To remove a selection, you can just click outside the image. By the way, you can also easily deselect any image by pressing Ctrl+D. There is one huge problem with this tool, which is otherwise very useful by all means. When you try to use it to isolate something from the background, and you select the background and try to fill it with white, it turns out that the selection is not very tidy, and all the dust and trash is still there out of its boundaries, and the edge of the product doesn't look very nice either. It depends on the tolerance setting, but if you try and use bigger tolerance values, the object will often be selected as well as the background. So it's only natural to keep the tolerance down to avoid this unpleasant effect, but when it's set to something low, a lot of background trash will be overlooked. I'm not going to explain how to deal with this issue now, so just keep this in your mind. When we get to the isolation process in detail, I will explain how to solve this problem. The next tool is very popular among the retouchers that I know. Judging by its name, the Quick Selection tool is supposed to create selections and quickly, which is in fact true. On the other hand, the selections it creates are usually far from perfect. Personally, I don't advise using this tool too much, but people love it, and during the quality control stage, I tend to see a lot of faulty isolations due to use of this tool without paying attention to the selections it makes. Let's first see how it works. The Quick Selection tool is similar to any brush. It means that you can draw with it, and you can also change the size, hardness, and other parameters of its tip. To select something, just click and drag your pointer over it, and the tool will do the rest. By the rest, I mean that it will determine what you're trying to select, and then it will try to select it as well as it can. Sometimes it works great, and it takes only a few seconds to select something. But this mostly happens if you have a solid object with definite smooth edges on a contrasted background. If you tick the Auto Enhance box, the tool will work much better but slower. This is a must if you wish it to create neat and tidy selections. Without the Auto Enhance feature, they are just worthless. Make sure it's checked. If the edges are not very definite, it's highly unlikely that you'll be able to make a proper selection with this tool. It will eat away parts of your objects if you don't pay enough attention. It also doesn't work very well on textures, so you won't be able to easily select the skirt despite the fact that it's dark and solid and contrasted with the background. All these flaws make the Quick Selection tool rather unpredictable and sloppy. If I were you, I wouldn't rely on it so much.